Hey, this is Mike. Before I get started, please subscribe to my channel. Right now, I'll wait for you. All right. Now, did you know that the 2015 Toyota Tundra, this is the XSPX SR5 Crewmax. A lot of names to this truck because it has a lot of features. But did you know that this truck has the ability to adjust the headlights on the fly from sitting right behind the driver's wheel? Also, do you know what the backup camera, the lines on the backup camera are for? Do you know what those are for? Did you know that this one has real carbon fiber? And do you know how to tell the difference between real carbon fiber and just fake stuff and just kind of look-alike stuff? Did you know that you can reset the tire pressure monitors on this truck from sitting right behind the wheel? And because when you rotate the tires, how does the truck know which tires is which? So you can do that in this truck. So I'm going to show you all that stuff in this video. So check it out. Subscribe to the channel. Like it. As soon as you see some value in this video, hit the like button and make a comment. Ask questions throughout the entire video in the comment section. Clarifications, any of that stuff, please do that. But anyway, let's get started. I'm here at Sparks Toyota. They're allowing me to show you this awesome truck, 2015 Toyota Tundra. Like I said, it's an SR5 Crewmax, and it has the XSPX package, which adds a lot of cool stuff. As you can probably notice right off the bat, that this one doesn't look like your normal, typical, run-of-the-mill Toyota Tundra. This one is kind of tricked out. So, one of the things it adds, I mean, do I have to even say? Check out these aluminum wheels and these off-road tires. Now, the BF Goodrich All-Terrain TA is one of the most popular truck tires, and everybody just has a lot of positive to say about these tires. And so they went ahead and added those in this package. Also, it's a 20-inch alloy wheel, but it's blacked out with some satin paint, and you know, has some of the alloy aluminum is popping out through to give you that epic look. Now the Toyota Tundra, while we're here, it has massive brake rotors. It's like almost 14-inch brake rotors. They're ventilated, they're thick, they're wide, they're allowed to breathe, and they're paired up with brake calipers with four pistons. That's two on each side of the caliper, so it's really give you that stopping force to control the 381 horsepower 5.7 liter V8. So you got a bunch of power, you need some stopping power to match that. All right, another thing you'll notice that this one has these fender flares, bolt-on fender flares that really set it off, along with these tubular side steps. And there is a lot more. So let's take a look here in the front. You'll probably notice that it has these little LED strips down here as running lights, and you can turn those on and off if you want to. Also, the headlights are powered by halogen reflector headlights and fog lights as well. Now check out that grill. I mean, that is just stunning. That blacked out grill with the Toyota badge floating in the center, and then you've got that red X popping out at you. This is one of those trucks that just stands out among all the rest on the dealership's lot. All right, so let's continue on over here. Let's take a peek at the profile. You see that with the crew cab, the Crewmax has a very large back door, so you have plenty of room in this truck. You see the back door is bigger than the front. All right, so let's take a look here in the front. All right. You see the door is pretty much all black except for this metallic accent there, and you have the real carbon fiber here. And like I mentioned before, the carbon fiber, how you can tell the real stuff is this actually weaved. So you can actually see the different weaving of the fibers. It's not smooth. This has a little bit of a rough texture. So that's how you can kind of tell whether you're dealing with real carbon fiber or not, is whether you can actually see and feel the weaves. So you do have some pockets here at the base of the door, as well as a bottle holder too, which is awesome. And you do here in the threshold, you have the XSPX badge, real carbon fiber threshold, and I'm pretty sure that's a backlit at night, which I hadn't had a chance to see it at night, but I'm pretty sure it is. And look at the leg room, plenty of leg room. Does have a handle to get in and out of, as well as a step here, tubular side step. There's some more carbon fiber here on the dash. It's pretty much all over the place, but then you've got the embroidery here with the package and perforated leather seats with the contrast white stitching. This is all in gray. You have manual adjustments here on the passenger side. Also, the passenger has a little place to put their phone or, you know, some kind of stuff that happens to be in their hand. Glove compartment. And here's the glove compartment. It's kind of like a little shelf system. It's not really that huge, but you know, this truck has plenty of other storage options. Also, here's a little pocket here for putting phones and stuff, and it's kind of shared with the driver, I guess. All right, let's take a look at the back. Man, that's a big door. I mean, the back seat drivers are going to be super comfortable and have plenty of room in this vehicle. So here's the inside of the back door. And it has the same level of, pretty much the same level of storage there in the door. Still have the carbon fiber in the back as well. You got a little tweeter speaker, big speaker there. Got the soft to the touch stuff here and here. You have this bench seat that can fit three, you know, adults, no problem. And there's some stuff there that the vehicle comes with. Those are connectors for the different, like a latch system in the back for tying down stuff. Plus you have different care products for keeping up with it. So let's go ahead and flip the seat up. So you can see you have the ability to flip the seats up, and then you have this big area for cargo space. So you don't always have to use the bed as a cargo space. If you don't have any passengers back here, or even if you do, you have the ability to have a combination of cargo and passenger space here in the back. And that keeps whatever you're hauling out of the weather, and also it keeps it secure. Here's this armrest, pops down. Then you got the cup holders, and then you got a comfortable armrest there. You do have a power supply back here as well as some vents. There's your dome light. And you do have the carbon fiber threshold here in the back as well. Very impressive truck. And that's not all. There's lots more. You do have a chrome tip for the exhaust. Chrome bumper and black in the inside, basically. And there's your towing package. And this truck, these Toyota Tundras with the 5.7 liter, can tow up to like 10,500 pounds, something like that. You might want to, before you actually buy a truck, make sure it matches your towing capacity, your towing needs. So, you know, don't rely on my information there, because it is a safety hazard if you overload your truck. So you may definitely want to check with your dealer with that. So here it does have the 7-way and 4-way plugs here for plugging in different trailers. And if I'm not mistaken, this has a 430 gear ratio in the rear end, so it has massive amounts of power. All right, the Tundra back here is in carbon fiber. This word is in carbon fiber. Isn't that awesome? So you do have a locking tailgate, and so let's go ahead and I want to show you something. I'm going to release the tailgate. It slowly goes down. It's power, not powered, but it's assisted going back up too, so you can lift it up with just one finger. But going down, it just kind of slowly goes down. And part of that package that I mentioned before is the, you know, part of the XXPX is the spray and bed liner, which is a really good idea because the spray and bed liner gives you the ability to protect your truck from moisture and stuff. So like say a no bed liner is like no protection basically other than the paint, and that may scratch off. And a plastic bed liner will allow moisture to build up underneath it and possibly rust your bed. So this eliminates all that stuff. And it just looks better to me. So lifting up the tailgate is very easy, like I said, because it's assisted. And now you can lock your tailgate, even if you can have like a tonneau color cover to protect some stuff in the back, but also locking your tailgate, the ability to do that is really good because some people will steal tail lights or steal a tailgate, stuff like that. So you can just lock it up and not have to even worry about it. All right, so here's the fuel door. It is on the driver's side, which is convenient. You can take the cap off, hang it right here so it doesn't mess up your paint, and you're good to go on that. Let's get a look underneath the truck. That seems to help. Get an idea. People that are interested in trucks are kind of into all the mechanical stuff, which we will check out the engine too before it's over. Let's check out back here. Give you another perspective. You can see this one, this side lifts up as well, and it does secure itself in place. And that way you can use that cargo area. And this is truly a Texas sized truck because it is manufactured, it's built in Texas. So this is that kind of explains some of the size there. All right, heated side mirrors there. All righty. So let's go ahead and take a look under the hood. Covered up with plastic, so but the latch is right here in the right in the middle. You just reach in just to the right of the Toyota symbol and you just lift it up like that. But here it is, 5.7 liter V8, 381 horsepower, 401 pound-feet of torque in this neat little package here. Hey, I get to see a little bit of engine here. I don't cover it completely up, that's nice. Everything is secure, well designed, made to last. It does have the pistons there that keep the hood up for you. So as you lift it up, it'll raise right on up. All right, so let's take a look on the inside. All right, here we are on the inside. And this is an extremely impressive truck. You see all the carbon fiber everywhere? I mean, they just go ahead and put it everywhere. All right, so over here is the controls on the door. Of course, you have your door lock there and your handle, but right here where all the carbon fiber is, you have your power windows for all the doors, you have the door locks, and then you have the ability to lock out the rear power windows for the rear passengers. That's usually used for, you know, small children that you don't want to mess with the windows. So here is a whole bunch of buttons to the left of the steering column, and start here. This is for your side mirrors to control them and adjust them the way you want. You just have to choose left or right. And then you can control it with this pad here, up, down, left, right. And this button is for if you want to turn on all the interior lights, you can just push that. There in the center position, the door, when you open up the door, all the lights will turn on. You can also make it to where nothing turns on the interior lights. Even if the door is open, it's still dark in here. And that's useful for if you have like a child sleeping or something, you don't want to open up the light and all of a sudden all these lights are in their face and wakes them up. That's one use. Also, this, like I was saying before,
This you can actually adjust up and down the headlights depending on, like, if you have a heavy load that's slightly making the back of the truck, or if you have a trailer or something like that that's adding a bunch of weight to the back of the truck. Now the truck's tilted a little bit and your headlights are kind of shining up too high and blinding people. You can adjust those up and down to fine tune where you want the light to go. So this is a really amazing feature. I don't think I've ever seen that in any other truck or car or anything, to be able to, on the fly, adjust your headlights up and down. That is cool. So this right here is the same principle of this interior light button, except for it is for your cargo light. At the back of the cab, there's a light that shines in the bed. And so basically, it will allow you to make it, to just turn it on, have it turn on with the door, or just completely off. So that's that there. LED, these are those LED strips I showed you outside, your running lights. You can have those on or off, depending on what you want. Now here is another cool button. So I'm going to show you what that button does by aiming the camera back here, and then I'm gonna push the button. Oh yeah, power back glass. Isn't that awesome? It's just like your glass in the door, except for it's the whole back glass in the back of the vehicle. That is amazing. First time I've seen that as well. All right, so here's the steering wheel. It is a very rugged, like a soft synthetic material that's, it feels like it's indestructible. You could probably hit it with a hammer and not mess it up. So, but it is comfortable. It does give a little bit in your hand, so it doesn't fatigue your hand. You do have these bolsters here to give you some extra grip. And it's pretty simple. It does have some buttons on the steering wheel, but it is a pretty simple, comfortable steering wheel. So let's look here on this side. We have a volume button for your radio, so you can adjust your volume up and down. And these buttons are for your radio as well, to where you can change through, say, like I'm going up and down, going through those presets there. I'm gonna turn the volume down. And you can also change to the right or left, which is changing through the stations. And then you have a back button there. And also the center button is for making a selection. So you can go up and down on your presets and you push the buttons to select the preset that you want. Mode is for, like, say, AM, FM, satellite radio, the different types of inputs that you can use to play music through the system. That's what that's for. All right, on the right side of the steering wheel, we have a few things. And this part is for your phone. You can see it has a picture of a phone, of course. But once you pair your Bluetooth phone with the system, then when somebody calls you, you can receive the call by pushing this. So you're driving along, and all of a sudden, the radio dims out, you hear a ringing sound, you push this button, and you just start talking. You say hello, and you talk to the person. When you're done talking, you can push this button, and that hangs up. Now, if you need to make a call, you can push this button, the voice recognition button, and you can say, call a specific number, or you can say, call John Smith, or whoever happens to be into your phone book. So your phone book, it has to be, you know, you have to say it like it's spelled in your phone book. So that's a way of calling. Now, this voice recognition button is also for tuning through stations, and there's other commands that you can use besides just making calls with the voice recognition button. Very, very handy feature. It's useful, and it is an extremely good safety feature. This will keep your eyes on the road and hands on the wheel while you're doing all kinds of stuff. You can stay productive on the phone. You can stay productive changing the radio or whatever you want to do without compromising your safety. This is a really, really good system, and I highly recommend it in any vehicle. So this button down here, display, this corresponds with this blue screen here in the center of the gauges. Now, just looking at the gauges, you can see they're very easy to read. Simple, truck-like, I guess, kind of rugged-like. It has that kind of a rugged look and strong look.
But, you know, you have your RPMs there on the left. To the far left, the bottom, is your oil pressure. And this is very important to keep an eye on that. If it's too low, you certainly don't want to continue driving your truck. But it is a Toyota, so you don't have to really worry about that kind of stuff. Temperature, there on the top left, top right, fuel. And bottom right is your voltage of your alternator. And then you've got your speedometer there to the right. Now, center screen. Right now, it says exterior temperature is 95 degrees. Feels a little bit hotter than that. It's an extremely hot day. 177 miles on the odometer. How many miles the truck has. And so right now it says 138 miles to empty. So this display button, I can push it, and it's going to give me other information besides till empty. Elapsed time since you started. Average speed since you started. You can go into some settings by holding down. You can change the language and stuff like that. I can go in there. And average fuel economy since you've restarted it. And current fuel economy, which is, it'll give you like a bar will pop up there when you start driving and let you know exactly what you're getting in that moment. So you can see, well, I'm pushing the gas a little bit too hard here. It's really cutting down on my fuel economy, so I can, you can really kind of gauge how much gas you're using there. And then it scrolls back to distance to empty. So you do have a lot, pretty good amount of information there in the center of the screen. It's not stuff you have to constantly look at all the time, but it's there in case you need it. Alrighty, so up here in this top center, we have a speaker. And just below that, we have this quick access place. I guess you can put like a cell phone there. The only thing is that it's going to be affected by sunlight. So even in the wintertime, the dash gets really hot. So that's kind of an issue there. So it's something you want to temporarily put something there, not necessarily leave it all the time. Unless it's maybe a piece of paper or something and a pencil, I guess. All right, so down here, look at that center stack. I mean, it is really amplified, the awesomeness with the carbon fiber. Let me go ahead and quickly do these buttons before I go on to the center stack. And you can see it even has carbon fiber there. That left button, this is the traction control. You can turn that off. This truck will allow you to, when you turn this off, it'll allow you to spin tires, basically. So if you are stuck, or if you're in snow or some kind of situation to where you need to spin tires, you can turn this traction control off. Default is always on. So that's how you turn that off. Now, if you're hauling a trailer and it's, with any significant weight, you definitely want to push this button. It lets the vehicle know that you do have some added weight back there, and it will keep you from going into the extremely high gear ratios. Also, it will, hold your shifts a little bit longer, stuff like that. That way, for the longevity of the transmission and the truck, definitely want to use that button when you're hauling stuff. Before I go too much further, this is your headlight controls, and there's your fog lights. So this is your headlights, and fog lights are here. Windshield wipers are on that side. All right, so let's get back to the center stack. Really awesome looking. You can see it has the volume tuned through the stations. Real traditional design there with the volume on the left. Has actual knobs, that people are familiar with. And speaking of traditional, it does have a CD player still, which some people still use, I guess. So, the touch screen, you have the ability to touch the screen. You also have actual buttons on the right and left here of the screen in case you want to use those in addition to, and it's convenient. It will kind of work in conjunction with the screen here. So, the first thing I'm going to push is the audio button, and this will take us into all the different ways you can play audio through the system. AM, FM, satellite radio, CD, auxiliary input, Bluetooth audio, and USB. So lots of different ways to play music. So CDs are kind of old school. They've been kind of obsolete for, I don't know, at least 10 years now, but people still use them. But anyways, there's lots of other ways of actually playing music through the sound system. Pushing the home button will give you some kind of a combination between your phone, what your phone's doing and what your radio's doing. And then you can play and pause right there, your CD tracks or whatever. You can change through tracks there. Now pushing this apps button will give you a real quick access. It's kind of like in computer icons, to where you can go into your audio, your phone, your messages, you can set up stuff. Also with the HD radio and the satellite radio, it gives you the ability to have traffic and weather information as well. So going into the phone, can't really go into it unless a paraphone. So once you do go in there, once it's paired, you will have like a screen to where you can access your phone book. You can send recalls. It'll be like a dial pad there and all that stuff. So lots of cool stuff on that screen. You got this Tundra, the name Tundra down here. Four-way flashers are here. And so now we're going into the climate control zone. You got your fan speed. And I do have the air conditioner on because it's, like I said, it's very hot. Fan speed is here. The dials are really easy to, you know, turn, and also they're big enough to where even if you have gloves on, or you can turn them and it's no problem. Your temperature is here, and where you want the air to blow is there. And you can see the carbon fiber where they actually put the paint over top of the carbon fiber, so you can really tell that it's real because it's textured. And also in this light here, you can see the actual weaving. Alright, so that's pretty simple. Everybody's pretty much familiar with that, I'm sure. And right here is your four-wheel drive controls. It's as simple as turning a knob. Right now it's in two-wheel drive. You can turn it to four-wheel drive high or four-wheel drive low. Down here, out of the way, because it's not something you use regularly, this is where you reset your tire pressure. So like say, tire pressure monitoring system. So if you have a tire rotation, say you're supposed to pretty much have one at every oil change pretty much. So you push that and that recalibrates all your tire pressure monitor system to where it knows where the tires are now. You're just letting it know, hey, we need to reset that, and it does its thing. It has some kind of sensing ability. So pretty cool there. You don't have to like hook it up to any kind of computer or anything like that. All right, like the older vehicles. So under here we've got two power supplies, but also this is where you'll find your auxiliary and your USB inputs. And of course you can use the USB for charging, but playing music through the system, all that good stuff. Then down here we have a kind of like a cup holder there, where you can use it for putting stuff, and quick access kind of pocket there. This is really cool here for cell phones, really handy for pins or cell phones or anything there. And you know, you can row up a whole bunches of them. You can also lay them down like that, that kind of thing. Cup holders are pretty good sized, and you can, you know, even a cell phone can fit in there like that. Place to put some coins, I guess, there. All right, so here's the shifter, and the shifter's, you know, pretty simple design. Let me go ahead and, it's easy to move too. Go ahead and put it in reverse. And when I put it in reverse, you will see the backup camera pop up. And you'll notice as these lines there. Now the lines are guidelines. And the reason why it needs guidelines is because this is a wide angle lens to give you the most visibility behind the vehicle. You'll notice it shows you from the bumper to the sky and all the way left and right, but it's distorted because of that wide angle lens. It's like a fisheye lens, or like a GoPro lens. It's distorted a little bit, and this one in this case is actually distorted quite a bit. So to compensate for that, to kind of help you as you're backing up, these lines show you about how wide your vehicle is as you back up, so you can get an idea of where you're going to go. Also, this red line is literally that. You don't want to go past that line. You don't want to get closer. If you back up to something, stop at that red line, because this little section here is not the same distance as down here. This is like maybe an inch or two. Very, very, very close. Just a few inches. Down here might be a few feet. So that distortion, you know, these lines are really helpful for you backing up. That's what they're for. So anyways, let's continue down the shifter, and let's go down to drive.
And this is the drive position in which you would just drive around, and you know, you don't have to worry about changing gears, that kind of stuff. It's just, you know, that's everything is taken care of for you. Now, if you need to downshift, or if you need to have any control over the gear ratio of the transmission, all you have to do is push it over here to the left, and now it's in what they call a sport mode, to where you can manually shift through the gears like this. So when you bump it, it's going to show you right here what gear you're in. So right now in first, I'm going to second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth is a 6-speed automatic transmission. Now, I don't know if it's going to actually allow you to start off in sixth gear, but you do have the ability to adjust the gear ratio to your needs, especially handy if you're going downhill and you need to use some engine braking by downshifting. That's a really good feature. So that's the basics of the shifter. Yes, there. And right here is another place where you can, I guess, put your cell phone. Fits mine perfectly, actually. So lots of neat places to put stuff. And this armrest lifts up, and it has some place to put some pens under here and cards and all kinds of different things. But also you have this huge storage area for, it's going to get cluttered. I'm just letting you know that in advance. And there's another power supply. Now it does have this little groove here to allow wires to go in and out to the power supply, so that's good. All right, so up here is your rear view mirror, and you notice it has a bunch of buttons on it. Some of those buttons, the ones with the little houses, are for the HomeLink garage door opener control. The ones here to the right, this is for your compass. You can turn that on and off if it's distracting you. So the digital compass will tell you which direction the vehicle's facing. So right now I'm facing southeast, so you can turn that on and off. This button turns on and off your auto dim rearview mirror. So it'll go into night mode automatically. Also, it'll self-adjust if somebody has their high beams on and blinding you, that kind of stuff. Pretty advanced rearview mirror, I guess you can say. All right, so up here, have a place to put your sunglasses or safety glasses, that kind of thing. Has a little place to put, you know, your registration or, you know, checkbook or something in that area, paper. You have a tap light for a quick access reading light individually. Right here we have the visor with lights. Also, this visor will slide out in and out to give you the, you know, the ability to turn it in different ways and really block out the light wherever you need it to. Alright, we've got airbags pretty much all over the place. And let's look at the visibility. Plenty of room back there. Alright, there you have it, 2015. Toyota Tundra with some awesome ads. That's my opinion. I like them. So anyways, the whole purpose of this video is to give you the information that you need to make a decision when buying a vehicle. So I'm trying to add value to your life, and I'd really appreciate it if you would reciprocate and give me some positive feedback in the description and in the comments. Also like the video. And also send me a tip. I have the ability to support my channel. It really helps me out, keeps me going. It's not even possible without without resources. So I really appreciate your time, and I appreciate Sparks Toyota for allowing me to check out and show this off to the world. I do not work for Sparks Toyota, I work for you. So, so anyways, just wanna let you know that, and thanks for watching. Please sub, please like the video, please comment, and I'll see you next time.